Everybody, it's Evicta. It's time to Teenage Drink here, the Binding of Isaac Evicta Repentance series. Well, 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 we are living in a post-all-kill, full-house, clear-run world. Man, that run was just, it was something else. Thank you all very much for those of you who went and watched that saga, that movie. If some people even called it a feature film, I wouldn't go that far. But thank you, and welcome all new subscribers here to the Mosh Pit. It's great to see you. Thank you for keeping up the Light Streak goal, which is now only seven away now, 7 days away from the Light Streak counter, reaching its goal and getting us to the all alt path week, which is going to be a lot of fun, assuming that the streak is still going on by that point. Who knows? Here's your meme of the day. Also, artwork of the day brought to you. Beautiful artwork by, I'm going to say, Carol Miz. Oh, the thread was, watch out, Pin. It's Invicta with a suplex. Also, hi, this is my first time posting after watching Sin for 2+ years now. Thank you very much to Carl Miz. Oh yeah, brother! Pin looks terrified. He should be, because I'm about to suplex him to Australia. I don't know. Top in. And you may have noticed that we did actually gain Eden tokens because of how many times we killed Mom's Heart in that last run. Seed Day is gonna be 0 Hotel, 6 Victor, 2 Whiskey, 2 Sierra. Got once again terrible got really bad tears rate again and really, really bad movement speed. We have a Hierophant card and the poop. Starting off here, good damage because we also have Blood of the Martyr, and we also have the Steel Bar, which is the result of us getting Eden's Blessing during yesterday's run. Very, very awesome to just to have experienced that and seeing everyone's reaction. I almost made it I saw it was a moon card, by the way, game. You can't, that's a lot better. It was awesome to see everyone's reaction to yesterday's run. I almost made it a live premiere, but I was like, I don't know how live premieres interact with the algorithm or vice versa. So, and on top of that, it is a very, very long video, and I want to be respectful of people's times as well. So decided to go against the live premiere thing. Okay. We have the coupon here, which is going to guarantee a half price item in the store. We can also get free devil deals without having to be charged HP for them. And I think that we also can go in and get a devil deal item without actually getting a deal with Devil Preston. What's going on with this? That's like the world's most obvious schmoove right there. So obviously we have this Hierophant card, which I don't have currently in my possession. But I will most likely use it. And then we're going to take this moon card down to the next level. Potentially. Now, I know that is probably the right way to go down south here, but I want to see if there's a mini boss up here. Well, maybe it's not. We'll see. So there's a lot to decompress after yesterday's run. Obviously, you know, the biggest story is, of course, us just dominating everything in the game. And when I say everything, I mean there was no stone left unturned. The only thing that we didn't kill in that run was, of course, Super Greed and Ultra Greed, but obviously we can't do that because it's literally not in the game to be able to do that. We would have to exit that run and then somehow transfer the seed over to Greed mode, and I don't think that's even possible. Although that would be fun to do. That would be pretty neat if you had, like, if there was one way for you to just, to, like, one really secret, arbitrary way that you could get into Greed mode, then that, I guess that would be the ultimate all-kill run, is being able to beat Ultra Greed in one run along with everything else. But you saw how much stuff that we had to go through just to get to that point. And, of course, going through all the crashes and everything. I mean, Isaac has been unstable for years. I mean, we've seen it crash many, many, many times. It just happens. Sometimes it doesn't even happen on runs that you break stuff. Sometimes it just freaking crashes. I mean, it sucks when it happens. I really wish that the game would be better at, like, not having to restart the entire level when that happens, but what can you do? We do have enough HP to make the sacrifice room kind of tempting, but this is too much HP to kind of waste at the start here, I think, and I'm not willing just to throw away, you know, 5 soul hearts and a whole bunch of red hearts. If we were gonna flirt with the idea of actually going after the sacrifice room, then we should have tapped it a few times before picking up the soul hearts. But even then, we're unlikely gonna get much out of it. I mean, the best thing we can hope for is maybe get teleported to the angel deal or devil deal, But yeah, in my opinion, not worth it. And Curse of the Blind. Not too many Curses of the Blind in yesterday's run, although one in particular was the worst one, obviously, with us getting Curse of the Blind on the boss rush. And then, like, the amount of worry that I went into picking up that one and only one item from the boss rush with the possibility of it being missing, no, was, like, through the roof. But had it happened, I mean, like, that's the most Sinvicta way to go out, right? Like, out of all the items that could have spawned on a Curse of the Blind, we happened to go to boss rush and that happened to be missing, no? I could see it happening. Tell me you couldn't see that happening. I wouldn't believe you. There are bombs back here, which is pretty good. Okay. Sure thing, game, because apparently spiders can jump that fast. Sure thing. They just get faster and faster, these spiders. No reason for us to do anything here just because it's Curse of Blind. We could go use the coupon to sneak a Devil Deal item. But honestly, yesterday's run was built by the stairway. And getting stairway again would be pretty awesome. I mean, it's a super rare item. It's not like we're ever going to see it again, at least not today. Unless we somehow get Death Certificate or something. Get more HP, hooray. Yeah, take it. Not gonna take the other one again because I don't want to get locked into the Devil Deal, so we'll never know what that one is. If, by the way, if you're wondering where all this stuff is coming from on the ground and why we keep getting it over and over again, it's because we have Myosotis. Anyway, upon up to four uncollected items from the previous store will spawn in the starting room. That's where that is coming from. We can use the moon card to get out of here without having to get charged a full soul heart, and I'm fine with that. Might as well use one of our fast bombs to destroy the keeper and raise our chance of getting something to almost 40%. Practically 40%. Pentagram's gonna give us a nice damage up. Of course, we're still looking for tears here. We don't really want HP anymore. So if we can calm that down a little bit, game, that'd be pretty bueno. I wish I wouldn't know that there was a boss trap room, mob trap room over here, challenge room. Because I would have used the moon card to get out of here. Yeah, we get Guppy's Eye. Guppy's Eye is at least going to be able to show us what's inside of chests, what's inside of fires, that sort of thing, to kind of like let us know if us using our very limited amount of keys is going to be worth it or not in these chests. And it would also do. It also counts as a Guppy item. It also would allow me to know if doing these challenge rooms are worth it or not, because I'd be able to see the contents of the chests. And that's a very powerful thing, is not wasting time in Isaac. I mean, sometimes, obviously, like, the game is just going to waste your time, period. But whenever you can mitigate that sort of time wastage, the better. Because then you can focus on gameplay, you focus on your positioning, and that all that sort of thing. You don't have to worry about wasting time. Like, oh, we got to get to boss rusher. Oh, you know, is this one worth it or not? I don't know. We might take an extra hit or two. 33% chance of adding extra blind item rooms. To item rooms, reveals blind item in alt path. Sure. Okay, cool. We get almond milk. Our first blind item. Appreciate that. Yep, really appreciate that, glasses. So, almond milk is basically like soy milk, except not. Oh man, if we can get car battery coupon, we're definitely going Devil Deals here. Car battery coupon would be pretty bueno. It'd be pretty muy bueno, mucho. Spanish speakers. No! Sinvicta, stop! You're murdering our language. I love the Spanish mosh pit. One day when the world is relatively calmed down and somewhat normal again, I'll dream of having a Spanish speaking mosh pit outdoor party. You know, and people can just come from miles and miles away just to hang out. We'll have a big old fiesta. I bet you I'm gonna have some of the best quesadillas this side of freaking Texas. I can tell you that, brother. If any of y'all out there can cook good quesadillas, hit your boy up. Or better yet, if anyone has a food truck, if you own a food truck, especially down here, and you sell quesadillas, I'm in heaven. Let's just throw the party right now. Sign me up. Golden chest inside of this chest here, which is going to have a soul heart and 3 pennies. Oh, and a rotten heart, apparently. So obviously, we really, really, really want to get... okay. Neat. We really want to get... a car battery coupon that basically frees us up to get all kinds of free stuff from the store and from the devil deal. Remember the appeal here is the free devil deal items we can get out of this. The store is good too. These schmooves, man, I'm telling you, they're astounding today. But getting free stuff from the store is good as well, but obviously the biggest appeal, especially when we need damage right now with having almond milk, is going to be going for devil deals here. That'd be a dream, man. Just being able to like say, hey, like mosh pit community meetup fiesta. Just have a bunch of food trucks. Have like a mariachi band and playing. Like there's something about Latino music that I just love. I love hearing it because it puts you in like a festive mood. And music really drives depending on like how I'm feeling that day, sometimes music can really drive my emotions, me personally. And there's just something about when I listen to Latino music that just I'm just like things are going on, like it's festive, like I want to like hang out, play games, like, you know, talk with people, just sit down, you know, just chill. Not even chill, just have a good time. When I hear the accordion start firing up, man, I'm already happy. Whoop. We already went in this curse room, right? Was that the last room that we went? Was that the... I think it was this floor's curse room. All right, so we really, 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 really want car battery here. Now, I can reduce the chance of that happening, or I can just simply buy it. We can increase the chance of it happening, I mean. I'd like to get it for free, though. Yeah, buddy. Now, in actuality, what I should have done, I should have just bought it there, because then I would have had a full charge for this upcoming possible devil deal. Nah, we won't get a devil deal, and if we do, it's gonna be Krampus. We have, we already know that. We know this ain't gonna be no good devil deal. Plus, we got HP to get it anyway, so it doesn't matter. I am so mad that hit us. I have to remind myself that our movement speed is only 0.89. He told you. I did kind of tell you. 73% base now for us to get a double deal here. We want damage. We want movement speed. Movement speed, I would actually take over damage right now, currently. What is that? Barely concussive tears just make flies be like, oh, I'm going to stay here. I'm going to stay here. I'm going to stay right next to you. I'm going to blow up. All right, take two here, bomb fly. Store obviously here first. Well, really, we should look for the boss first, because if we get this devil deal, then we're going to want to get it for free. That is, of course, assuming that we actually get a devil deal and not like a Krampus fight. Found the vampire. I mean, 10 bombs would have been kind of nice. Also, I think the broken glasses have procced every floor since we've gotten them so far. That's not normal. I don't think it's here, but it could be. Boy, howdy. This shop right here, let me tell you about this shop. This shop right here, this is a shop right here. Maybe the secret room's up here. All right, sitting at a 78% chance for a deal with the angel or deal with the devil. The thing that I don't like about almond milk are the tears that don't fly straight. Like the ones that get like My Reflection and Ouroboros Worm, those are the ones that like I need to like, it's always like, it seems like always it's like the last hit, like one more hit and we could have gotten this one. Old blue baby. So I think the super secret room is above, it's north of the room that we tried bombing into the right side for. I'm almost positive that it's there. Let's go back and drop that real quick. Like I said, it's not there. What are you talking about? I told you it wasn't there. We hit with one of them. There we go. Get an angel deal, another HP upgrade. They are souls. And dabby-tastic. Oh boy. Well, Purity and Worm Buddy, but fortunately we don't have the keys to get in there. The problem right now is that we're getting, I mean, HP upgrades, like, that's grand and all, it's fine. Get a planetarium. We only skipped one item room, but really don't like Mars, but can you dash through curse rooms? Oh, thank you, game, for doing it now. Nope. Wouldn't have mattered anyway. Our movement speed is just not good. Pretty sure that Mars was my first ever planetarium item that I got, and I was not too impressed with it the first time it showed up, and I'm still not really impressed with it. You know what? That bomb is lost forever. Actually, wasn't even trying to jump that way. It startled me a little bit that we even moved there. Look at that, we have a little steam trail coming off our nose. Okay. And now this is when we're going to start seeing the early event. Dude, Mars, I didn't even double tap down there. We're going to start seeing the shortcomings of this build. The fact that our movement speed is 0.89 is very dangerous. Almond milk, we can make up the DPS differential by getting tier effects or on hit effects like lead pencil, for example, which is a very good tier effect to get. Obviously, because we're firing so fast, we're going to be just throwing out the lead pencil effect almost every half second or so. But what we really, really want is a good on hit, on proc tier effect, like Holy Light. I always bring up Holy Light, or Jacob's Ladder, something like that. Okay, well. Funny game. Literally had a 66% chance to get that. And we failed. I wouldn't mind converting some of this red heart HP into damage via the potato peeler. I'm not willing to spend 15 cents for it. See, I tap that. I actually tried to dodge that. I was going to be slick. Like, oh, I'm going to dodge with Mars. And then, like, it didn't go off. So we fail a 37%-ish, 36%-ish deal with the devil run. I mean, I guess technically we don't really need the money if we're going to be using coupon, but like we could also run into a situation where we do fail a 66% chance to get something again. We only have one key, so getting into the mega chest is not going to work. We need more keys. Get a third key here, we might have a chance opening the mega chest. I wouldn't mind getting purity. All right, well, we got three keys. Three gonna be enough. It is. Purity gave us a tears up. Oh boy. And Worm Buddy. All right, Worm Friend, let's do this. When you need a big time player, they come up with the big time plays. We're going to be able to get the potato peeler for free. And we even need an HP upgrade. I'm willing to go like 5 here. I almost walked up and just bought it. There we go. All right. We got a little bit more damage, and that's really good with this fire rate. Anything at this, whenever you're firing this fast, any level of damage upgrade that you can get is huge. Big for DPS, it's big for everything. A level 4 meat boy is also going to be very useful at helping us create some supplementary damage. I miss boss rush. We get another planetarium, excuse me? We don't even have magic 8 ball. That is uncanny. This ain't no Jupiter like Saturn thing either. We just got, oh God, sure, why not? We just got 2. Oh my God, what is this? We just got 2 planetariums. This is absurd. I'm not even like tapping. This is me just holding down. Have you ever seen Tech X fire this fast? I personally have not. And it's piercing and spectral too, which is real nice. So we get Neptune, or Pluto rather, which allows us to walk between rocks, which can be used for defensive purposes. And imagine if we get a lump of coal with this, that would be insane damage. So I haven't found our store yet. I want to go find our store mainly because I want to boost the chance of us getting a devil deal here. I mean, the damage looks pretty, it looked pretty good. Okay, good. We get a full charge here. That means we can use the coupon inside of the store and still have a full charge ready to go for the devil deal if we get one. And imagine if we get like Sacred Heart or something with this build. That's just an absolute butt ton of damage. I mean, cumulatively right now, we're doing a lot of damage. We can't bomb into the, let's see if we have a donation machine in our arcade. We don't, but we have the starter deck. Cricket's head, oh man. Big time play. 1.43 damage. That is massive. That is massive. I can't believe we got a second planetarium. That is nuts. So now 3.89 damage. We lost the tears rate because of us getting hit. Thanks to purity, but I think it goes without saying that we're going to be fine here. And if we get like the damage upgrade from purity, that would be even better. 73%. That's some good Invicta luck. I have never seen this room in my life. It's a very weird room. So Lazarus, we could hold on to that just in case if we died. Sure. If we die while holding on to the soul of Lazarus, we become Lazarus the second. So it's basically like having an extra life in your pocket. And the first time that I saw that rune, I had no idea. I thought it just turned you into Lazarus the second, which is not true at all. Well, technically that is true, but it also kills you and takes all your HP. And it's not good. Not good when you don't need to die. I'll even get a library. By the way, shout out to Purity for not giving us the movement speed upgrade. I think we gotta go book a Belial here, right? No, let's stick with the coupon. Let's keep the faith. We have faith in the coupon. Because we are going to need this extra HP for sure. Secret room might be here. I'd be surprised, but there's a chance. Oh wow. Color me surprised. Warm buddy, the absolute ledge. Warm buddy just sits him down and we just knock him out of the park. But my God, can we get some movement speed? By the way, that is called we did an Isaac circle right there. Yep. Yepers. Look at that map. And I'm so hard dropping, cool. Look at this map. Super Secret Room might be left of there. I'm almost certain that it is. Yep. Sure, I guess. I mean, it doesn't really help us out right now, but unless we get a devil deal. Worm Buddy, destroying worlds. Did get a double deal and yet another. I think we've gotten an HP upgrade off of every boss except for Squeezy. Monster Manual, Bookworm. Sissy! Never mind. It was all worth it, Sissy. Little sissy. Making the crowd go wild, sissy. Don't worry, she's gone now. We get 5 bombs here. Mom's box. Hey, okay, good. Good talk. That's right, poop is... I mean, if we end up doing a victory lap, which we might, this Hierophant. If we end up doing a victory lap, then maybe the petrified poop would be good, but... Oh, that's fun. Okay. I don't even know how we got up there. Isaac is so small because of Pluto. It's hard for me to tell. Like I keep seeing Meat Boy and thinking that like that's me, like thinking that's Isaac. I am gonna go in the curse room just to try to get a better purity aura. What do we get? We got range again. And we got damage! It's better than range. And also a dead end. Alright. Alrighty. Edo Mosquito. That mosquito right there, he's real neat. Actually, there's nothing good about mosquitoes. I saw a video the other day, like... What would happen if all the mosquitoes just disappeared or something like that? And it was like nothing would happen. The world would be happier. Mosquitoes, like, they don't even provide like that much food for like birds and stuff. Birds are more, they're more interested in eating like bigger insects. Mosquitoes are just parasites. There's very few things in the world that I hate more than mosquitoes. I recently bought a bug zapper. For the backyard, because the backyard, like, it's like down here in Texas, like, mosquitoes get ridiculous, especially in South Texas because of how humid it is. And mosquitoes have been real bad this year. I've already talked about how, like, I swell up, like, I'm allergic to the bug bites. We get the siren song for a second time, or forgotten lullaby, whatever. So I've been getting a sense of satisfaction listening every time that zapper goes off. I know, oh boy, I got another one. Got me another one. Although there was this giant moth that got tagged by the zapper. And don't feel bad, because I have no problem with moths, except they're ones that like eat your clothes and stuff. But this one has a happy ending. That one actually did live and flew away, but it startled me because it was so huge. It was like a big, like, it looked like white and brown moth. Like it was big enough. It was one of those moths. It wasn't like an Atlas moth or anything like that, but it was one of those moths that was big enough to where like you could see with the naked eye and from a great distance too. You could see like the antennae, like they're feathery and kind of poofy. It was a big moth. And I was like, dude, how'd you even fit in there? And then I figured out that it probably stuck one of its legs through the little grate there, because they're not, I mean, this thing isn't designed to kill like bird size insects. It's just a regular old plain old cheapo bug zapper, right? And it was just sitting on the ground in the backyard, and I was just like, good lord, what is that? That's the biggest freaking moth I've ever seen. And it's just standing there kind of looking at me, and of course I'm a little wary of giant insects, so I'm like, I don't know. I don't like the look of this. Yeah. Could get the soul of the keeper, but I could also just not. I mean, we all remember the story of the locust in my shoe. I don't remember what episode I told that story in, but the long, long, long story short of that one was I was coming home from bartending one night, got home, and there was a locust. There's a locust literally in front of my front door in my apartment. And I'm like, man, I just got off work. Why we got to do this? Why do I, like, it's like 4 in the morning. Like, why do I have to be put in this predicament? Because, like, I don't like bugs. I just do not like insects at all. I think they're cool, but I don't like seeing them in real life. I'm definitely not afraid of them. But if one were to, like, jump at me, I won't sit here and lie to you to say, like, I wouldn't be slightly startled. You know, because, like, nobody wants, like, a fluttering little insect, like, around you, like, your ear and stuff. Like, it gives you the heebie-jeebies is what we call it. Anyway, so this giant, like, black and red locust is sitting here, and it sees me coming up the stairs, and it turns to me and just stares at me. So I'm thinking, like, how am I going to resolve this? Because we got a problem here, okay? Because it's, like, it's really late in the morning. I just want to go home, get in bed. Like, I want to go shower, get in bed, and go to sleep. Like, that's all I want to do. But then we got my dude over here sitting in front of my front door. And, you know, something has to be done. Oh, we went straight to the boss. I am going to go back and go get Abba Dabba Ding Dong. Because not only is that damage, but it also gives us movement speed. I'm going to wait till we get a full charge on the coupon. So I'm just like, man, all right. I hate to do it, but I got to get inside of my door. I'm sorry. I can't let you claim this territory. So I took my shoe off, my work shoe, and I threw it at it, right? And I threw it with enough force that if it hit directly, it probably would have killed it. But I wasn't trying to kill it, if that makes sense. I was just trying to move it. You know, and I would have gotten my shoe the next day, or could have kept the shoe. It's like, whatever. So I threw it, and it hit the locust, and I was like, oh, it's got to be done. Like, it's just donezo. But then, like, freaking Mothra coming over the mountain, this locust, like, climbs up and perches on the shoe that I just threw at it and is still looking at me. Second run, 4 over, Rift 4. So I'm just like, you know what, dude? You know what? You can have that. That shoe is yours. That shoe is definitively yours. That's fine. And my hope was that I hit it hard enough to, like, stun it, so it, like, doesn't try to jump at me as I'm, like, trying to, like, you know, scoot on by into my front door. And I was able to squeeze on by, and then that was it. And I took my shower and went to bed. Not without a few kind of, like, ugh, moments, but, you know, I was able to get inside safely. What became of the shoe, I have no idea, but I hope it's out there surviving and living its best life. No, I woke up the next day, and it was my shoe was there, and the locust was thankfully gone. And yes, the thought had slipped into my mind at one point that it could have been in the shoe. Trust me, that was the first place I looked. Alright, card. I'm going to hold on to the Soul Lazarus just in case something happens, but I don't foresee something happening on this run. Loving our movement speed now. We get a level, a floor one fallen? Nani the heck? This build really came together here. I'm shocked. I'm really shocked that Tech X is even firing like this. Yeah, I just don't like bugs. I like learning about them. I like looking at them. But, like, I just don't like being around them, because, like, insects are, like, unpredictable and stuff, you know. And most of them mean you basically no harm. In fact, almost all of them mean you no harm. But that doesn't mean I don't like the look of you. Like, it's like, okay. It's like, yeah, I understand that, like, you know, it's like, I understand that, like, you know, spiders are great and all, and they help out. I mean, we have little Sissy and everything, and that's cool. But, like, I don't want you crawling on me. I don't want you crawling on my leg. I don't want you descending down like you do every single freaking week. Somehow I get these baby spiders that just descend down in front of me as I'm recording late at night. I don't know why. I don't know where they're coming from. The craziest thing, man. I guess I didn't have to do that, but... Blood bombs. We're able to see these because we have the glasses, by the way. Broken glasses. I'm not going to go fight Mother. Yet. Maybe. The Golden Bomb and get Dreamcatcher. I will take Dreamcatcher. Recall. Whoa there, Mars. Don't ever do that again. You need to calm it down there. Okay, we did get the damage upgrade from Purity. Herdlet, more like Deadlet. I wonder what this is going to do. We're just going to permanently have a 50-50 chance for an angel deal, I guess. Is it me or did that scene play twice? That was weird. We know one's Jawbone, the other one's like Rainbow Baby or something. I don't know. Something we don't care about. I want to keep the damage upgrade here that we get from Purity, so I'm not going to go into the curse room. I'm happy with his damage. Damage is actually really excellent. Party time, excellent. Need more Wayne's World references in our lives. This might be a little bit of a hot take, but I've only seen Wayne's World all the way through once. And I'm going to be honest, I think it's overrated. I think it's just kind of overrated. Like even when like the whole cultural wave of Wayne's World was going on with Mike Myers and Dana Carvey, like I still didn't find it all that funny. I'm just being honest. Like I'm just like, yeah, okay. These dudes are like, you know, shooing and all this stuff. I'm like, Guess I mean, that's comedy right there. Now, there's some people that just hold like the Wayne's World movies in like super high regards. Like, oh, it's a legend of a film and all this stuff. And I'm just like, the truth is, I've never been into movies that much. I'm not a movie guy. I'm really not. I do like some movies. And I don't like some movies. Maybe we'll get an Emperor card or something. Get a Justice card.
Justice.
Joker. Good. Queen of Hearts. Okay. Ace of Spades. All right. Strength. Let's use the Queen of Hearts.
Queen of Hearts.
Let's use the Ace of Spades. After. Well, let's go into our end room first. I guess we could have just dropped it in here because obviously we've got Goathead, so it doesn't matter. And I'm going to use the Ace of Spades in here. Give ourselves a whole bunch of keys. Multidimensional baby, you're making it real difficult to see where I am. I'm just letting you know, bro. As we get the key piece. There we go. Got our damage back. So that's all I wanted. That appeared to be a second multidimensional baby, which again, I have no interest in. Earthright, well, we know what this does, don't we? I'd like to get a nickel here. All right, so we get a free tarot cloth. Excuse me? Oh, we don't. It's still 7 cents. You just can't see it. Oh boy. The Thank you, Birthright. It's very, very useful. Yeah, the tower card, we can use it in a big room to spawn a bunch of, spawn a bunch of tinted rocks. All right. Yep. Get all them tinted rocks. Literally spawn none. Good. Quite bueno that was. We get a sun card. We can use that for one of the later floors. This is mines one. We're going to have to leave the mines next floor. What? Cubby's eye, you okay? Look tired. Hey, Great Gideon. Hey, boy, doing his best. Oh my god, did you see the fire right there for a moment? Holy crap. The Nine Tails gives us damage, which is good. We get Maw of the Void, which I think we all know how we feel about Maw of the Void. Hey, Leviathan though, that's pretty good. We'll take Leviathan. That was X-ray specs and Mom's bottle of pills. Emperor World card. Use the Sun card now. We got our. That's the one thing I was worried about, was losing the damage aura. We got our aura back, so that's good. Okay, we'll take X-ray specs just to have the. Just to save us the time of. Placing bombs and stuff, we can just walk through secret rooms. Got ourselves the tough twins. Go get growth hormones. Excellent. We needed movement speed. Happy to have it. Where did our... There it is. And we just get Abba Dabba Ding Dong again, I guess. That is going to give us more damage and more movement speed. Nice. Not a huge fan of Lodestone. The world. Lodestone is kind of like Strange Attractor. It doesn't really, in my opinion anyway, it doesn't really help out as much as it just gets in the way. Sometimes it can do good things like group up enemies and stuff, but most of the time it just doesn't. Curse of the Tower. Gosh, look at this tears rate with the blue aura. The blue aura from Purity. Good lord. Oh, we know the other one's lodestone, and I'm not taking lard, so. We know it's lodestone because we saw it. Even though it's not showing up anymore, we saw it. Game. Through secret room. I'm just gonna check it. Prefer not to lose this tears rate if at all possible. I'm gonna buy the soul heart. We have a good chance of getting an angel deal here. We get our angel deal and Spear Destiny. Oh my gosh. When Worm Buddy like just grabs on, it is crazy good. I guess. Hey, everybody.
The fool.
All right. Got ourselves a nice little victory lap going on here. Not too shabby, not too shabby. Run definitely turned out to be something pretty nice. Oh man, it's already been an hour? Oh my gosh. Didn't think it was an hour. Gonna be Mama Gertie. Okay. Needless to say, I think we're going to be able to just fly through the rest of this run. And trying out Punishing Gray Raven on mobile. Well, I mean, technically it's for mobile, but I've been playing it on the PC, obviously. Using LD player. Very fun game, very satisfying combat. I'm learning more and more and more about it. I talked about it on live stream before. I think I even mentioned it maybe during yesterday's video. I'm not entirely sure. But if anybody's playing Punishing Gray Raven, let me know what you think of it, because it seems pretty darn good. I like the fact that it's skill-based. I don't mean like your characters in the gacha game have skills. I mean, they do, but I mean like it's actually skill-based. Like there's combos, there's like quick time events, all sorts of cool stuff. And, and the fact that it's not competitive, so there's no PvP in the game that I know of anyway, it's really neat. Got a really cool art style. I've always been a fan of the anime, like cyberpunk-ish, future tech-ish type games. And Lobotomy Corporation is the first one that I can think of. We're 2 or 3 for Guppy. So we have a chance of getting the Gupster. Yeah, Lobotomy Corporation definitely comes to mind when I think of the anime. It doesn't even have to be like waifu stuff. It can just look anime. Futuristic, technology savvy, like techno-punk stuff. It looks, I don't know, I've always enjoyed it. And Punishing Gray Raven has a lot of that. Now, as far as the story is concerned, dude, I don't know. if you get thought that I don't care about stories and like, you know, major releases and single player games and even WoW and stuff, I do not. I care even less about the story of gacha games. if you told me what the story was, I'd be like, sure, brother. That sounds like a story to me. I want my fire rate back, damn it. Alright, damage is fine too, I guess. Oh my god. Magician, or... Get one last devil deal for Guppy. Yeah, hungry soul. You know, that Guppy item. And sure, let's go see him. Let's go see old Hushy. That was Parasite and something else. I think this is going to just give us damage. No movement speed. Okay, fair enough. Parasite even work with this? I don't think it does. It does. Well, it does with the... it does with the lead pencil. Can't take BFF. Ah, we don't need BFF. Oh, no, we gave it the coupon. Never mind. Don't listen to me. Now, if we do take damage, I'm going to try to get hit in a good spot that we can utilize Hallowed Ground. Buddy, keeping old Hushy down, locking him down. We're actually killing the flies faster than they can spawn, which is great. Even Hungry Soul getting in there. Look at that. Did use the reverse magician card, so we should be practically immune from projectiles for a minute anyway. Look at the continuum. It's like they're making a path for us. There we go. No hit old Hushy. We'll take that. I heard the secret room open during the cutscene there. Spawns this trap door with a crawl space. Neat. Didn't actually mean to use the Book of Shadows there. But it doesn't matter. Down goes Isaac. And let's go see if this had been the ultimate run. Let's see if Mega Stanley would have opened up the door for us. Okay, Cancer. We do not want brittle bones. That would be a bad idea. Is it? I mean, I don't recall ever seeing Mega Stan even open the door at this point. Delirium. We're talking about the olden days here. You know, I gotta say, almond milk, the acquisition wasn't as bad as I was expecting it to be. It synergized very well with a lot of this build, but it wasn't really until Tech X that really things took off for the better. Obviously, Purity had a nice big part in it. Appreciate you, Purity. Pluto, thanks for just being there, making it very difficult for me to see myself. And thank you for watching, everybody. Seriously, I'll welcome all new subscribers here to the Mosh Pit. Again, if you want to know how to support my channel, the easiest way to do so is simply clicking the like button. That is the 100% most surefire best way to support my channel is clicking the like button. The view that you're giving me also, of course, matters, but the like button is everything to YouTubers and YouTube channels. And I thank you all very much. The comments would be the second best way to support myself if you wish to do both. That's above and beyond, and I really appreciate those of you who do go out of your way. We even have people who have comment streaks and like streaks, and also sign up for the Patreon, or is like a member of the YouTube Mosh Pit or the Twitch Mosh Pit. So thank you all very much. It speaks volumes to how awesome the Mosh Pit is, and don't think it goes unnoticed. I get tons of messages from friends who are all content creators who just talk about like how incredible our community is, and I'm very proud of that, and I cannot thank you all enough for being part of it. Thank you very much for making Isaac what it is. And for watching this video, Megastan, are we going to get in there or not? We are not. Thank you for watching, everyone. Again, like I said, click the like button down here if you enjoyed it. Click the dislike if you didn't. And as always, I will see you all next time. Have a great start to your Friday, everyone. Happy weekend. Thanks for watching this video. I'd like to thank some patrons of mine like Jared Barreto, Kristen Johnson, Nale Vikstrom, Colton Hanna, Peter York, and Benjamin Dupai. If you'd like to have your name read at the end of an Isaac episode, then check out my Patreon campaign, which you can find over at patreon.com/sinvicta.